like to introduce an AI which has quite a bit of interesting functionalities, and it's a little bit different than Midjourney and various tools that we saw so far. Maybe a little bit overlap with the Photoshop AI, especially the background diffusion and maybe the outpainting portions. Sketch rendering. This is a sketch where you can upload a sketch. Any sketch that you have in your mind, for example, this could be one of the sketch that we are looking for, and we can render a 3D image based on the sketches. So that's very interesting. So you can just say, for example, what are we looking for? Is it interior design, is it commercial space and architecture? And we can just say, for example, what kind of architecture it is. So creative in like this one, I would just say, let's say minimalist Miami, and I can just say beige, color beige tones and wooden claddings. And then I can just generate. So once I do this, what it will do is it will give me three variations of that particular sketch converted to this kind of a creative innovation, precise rendering. Obviously, you can just use multiple. And then you can just say different aspects that will give me a little bit more definition to these renderings. As you can see, it's like very, very interesting ones. So you can go ahead and play with a different combination. This is also valid for even furniture. It doesn't have to be specifically to every single, it could be like components, could be like space, could be landscape. There are lots of options that can be sketched, converted into more fine. So which we don't have to spend a lot of time. If you have already hand sketch, for example, of your concept designs and so forth, you can literally put them here and then generate a Photoshopped version of it right away. So I would actually say this is more like a Photoshop, like next level AI, which it just converts it to you. So you don't have to spend a lot of time on doing that. And then you can also do vice versa. You can also do photo to sketch. I'm not a big fan of this, but you can, it can be used because when you have this photo, of course, you can just do pencil line, for example, art, and then you can just say outline. And then here you can say, you don't even have to say sometimes certain stuff. So you can just hit generate and it'll still generate it for you. So I tried here a few versions already beforehand. And the biggest thing is that it doesn't really feel, in my opinion, that it's as if really hand-drawn. But still, if we need something like this, we can always pull it easily from a photo to sketch right away with this AI. I'm much more into in comparison to this. So actually, they're not really bad, I would say, like, or they're not really negative and so forth. I think these are a little bit better than the ones I tried before. I was like, maybe we shouldn't have any prompts, because then it makes it seems like it's making a little bit more realistic hand drawings. But I would still prefer this one, hand drawing and converting that into the sketch, into the real images and more presentable images, because I think that will have a bigger influence on our workflow. Still, this can be used whenever needed. Erase and replace, this is a very interesting tool. I actually did the first test by just selecting this one, and I selected the erase tool here. And then you can just select the, for example, the top portion of the roof. And what I did is that I said, make that portion to me a glazed roof, glazed interior. So that was very, very interesting. And I can try maybe different one here. So let's see if they say like a wooden roof, and let's see what it will generate. And most probably I will be able to see that. Yeah, the previous one, I did this one. So I said, I did absolutely the same thing. I just said glass roof, and then it gave me these three options, especially this one. This is a really good, it even follow the pattern of the curtain grids on the facade, which is really, really good. And then this was one of the glazing. I'm not sure if I'm a fan of this one. But again, yeah, wooden truss, it also shows different wood options, and just also had here interesting bit. Yeah, so you can create a different, you can erase different things and try to replace them with that AI. Image variation, this might be interesting, but I didn't find this very powerful. Maybe for a couch or so forth, it might be a little bit more interesting to use it. But when I try to use the other image, the one that I was uploading always, and it said image variation, these are quite different than the one that we actually used to upload, because as you can see, these are a different space, like it's more rectangular. The other one was more longer and a curved glazing, more felt like them having this type of L glazing or just this kind of a space. I think it does a little bit too wide variation. Again, you can do maybe like you can reduce this panel to less variations, and then it might we can just try that and see how much how different we can do. So as you can see, this variation of the furniture. But let's just go back to the variation. I will just go home. I'll just go image variation, and I will upload this one, and I will just do very little variation here, and let's see what it will do. Because as you can see, this has nothing to do with the images that are generated. So let's see on the slider on the lower end side how much it would variation would generate, like how different it would make it. So if it can keep it as close as the one that I have and with minor variation, that would be awesome. Otherwise, this is for me like too different than what we are seeing here. Even the space is a little bit different. Okay, so yeah, in this case, the variation slider should be much lower than the higher if you want. Same now. Now we are talking about the same space having different type of pool, maybe like jacuzzi or so forth, and different type of sun beds. And it has also plants and maybe different type of plants. The flooring is a little different, and the skylight or something would be at the top. And this is a different ceiling design. Very interesting. The AI supermodel, this is just it allows us to create a different supermodel generation. I think it is not applicable for our purposes. So I think this is also not applicable. This is more for product design, or if you want so particular thing and have a different background and background diffusion and so forth. In our case, we would definitely want most of the time not that. Maybe a building in the background to be changed. We can test this tool. It's absolutely work the same way. So you upload it and you just say what kind of furniture and e-commerce. As you can see, it doesn't have much of an impact of the building in the background. So it will be great for a particular purpose. Hey, we want to go this direction. How would it be best to achieve that particular thing? I think this is one of the most interesting ones that I found, and it's much more powerful than Photoshop AI, I think. Because it's like I did this kind of an image and I just made it smaller and I just created generate. So I didn't even add anything here. This can generate. And then it's filled the area, the remaining area, with addition to the space. As you can see, it's not perfect, but actually Photoshop AI does something similar, like very, very similar. However, I think this did a better job than Photoshop AI in the first impression. It will never be perfect though. So this is much better than the version that I want, but as you can see, we still feel that there's something on the floor. If you pay attention to detail, it was really definitely realized, but I think this was best out of the three. So I would do maybe more glass, more walls, and I would just do smaller like that. And then let's see. Will generate like more of a, presumably more of a glass ones on the side. And then there is the two other tools that are left on the left side, the text effects. This is also something that just to create different text and text like styles and so forth, which may not be just particularly used a lot in our case. And AI visual board, this is just, you can ask a few questions and it can help you to, you know, generate certain things, but it doesn't generate the views right away. So it's more about, you know, just to communicate if you have any questions or so forth. And I think the most powerful out of these tools you would use the first one, second one, the third one, the erase and replace, background, diffusion, and image variation is one of the most used ones as well. So as you can see here, as a final thing, we had more glass walls, added additional glass walls here as well. So it has additional glass. It fills the remaining space just to with a prompt that I was referring to. Right. If you have any question or if you want to have access to this, please make sure that you reach the IT team. If you like this video and more videos like this, subscribe to our channel because there will be many more. And don't forget to turn your notification bell on.